पाप विनाशक्तम् नित्यानन्दाय स्वागतम् आनन्दानुभवास्वरम् सर्वरोग निवारकम् वन्दे पाप विनाशक्तम् नित्यानन्दाय स्वागतम्।
नित्यानन्देश्वर समारम्भाम् नित्यानन्देश्वरि मध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्ताम् वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। इस समय हमारे साथ उपस्थित सभी दर्शकों और भक्तों का मैं प्रेम एवं आशीर्वाद सहित स्वागत करता हूँ। When you take responsibility for others, the extraordinary powers starts flowing through you. When you start enriching others, the whole cosmos starts expressing through you. Whenever you enrich others, the energy flows through you is cosmic energy. If you want to taste, experience cosmic energy, just start enriching others now, today. The excitement you feel, the freshness you feel, the readiness happens in you, the joy happening in you, the inspiration happening in you is cosmic energy. Pure cosmic energy. Your past karmas are burnt when you enrich others. When you enrich others to live with integrity, authenticity, responsibility, simply your past karmas are burnt. I have a story. एक सरदार अपने मैरिज सर्टिफिकेट को एक घंटे से देख रहा था। बीवी बोली, तुसी इन्हीं देर से की देख रहे हो? सरदार ने कहा, एक्सपायरी डेट ढूंढ रहा हूँ। Listen, your marriage depends upon the stability of your spouse. You cannot be complete in your marriage. Only if you are stable, you are integrated. If your spouse is not integrated, your marriage cannot be a successful marriage. In every step of your life, you will be successful only with others participating in it. Only when you enrich others, आपकी शादी आपके जीवन साथी की स्थिरता पे आधारित है। One story. A 20-year-old boy comes back to his father, confesses to him saying that I am in love with our neighbor girl. I am proposing to her. And I wanted to marry her. Father immediately collapses on the sofa and says, no, you can't do that. She is your half-sister. The guy is completely disturbed. Anyhow, obeys the father, comes back after a month with the next proposal saying the opposite house girl is in love and he is already proposed to her, he wants to marry. Again father collapses and says, no my son, sorry, she is also your stepsister. He begs, don't tell your mom, but it's too much. Third time again he comes back and same thing is repeated. Now it is too much, he is not able to handle, he rushes to his mom and cries, see what your husband has done, whatever my dad has done. Any woman I propose, he says, she is your sister. What can I do? Whom will I marry? Mother says, don't worry, my son, among the three you can marry anyone because he is not your father. Understand? Sometime the lack of integrity of people who live around you costs too much to you. So any completion, any fulfillment, any success is possible only if people around you are also living with integrity and authenticity and fulfillment and completion and responsibility. Without they living integrity, authenticity, responsibility and enriching, you can't achieve completion in integrity, responsibility, authenticity. So enriching is one of the important spiritual vow. In a way, when you enrich others, in few days it comes back to you as more enrichment. Enriching others raises your understanding about tattvas, finally comes back to you as higher enrichment. Jab aap dusro ka uttardayitv utate hai to aap mein asadharan shaktiya pradarshit hoti hai. यदि आप ब्रह्मांड की शक्ति का अनुभव करना चाहते हैं, बस आज से दूसरों का लाभान्वित करना आरंभ कीजिए. जब आप दूसरों को संपूर्ति श्रद्धा और उत्तरदायित्व के साथ लाभान्वित करते हैं, आपके अतीत के कर्म भस्म हो जाते हैं. आपके आसपास के सभी लोग जब उत्तरदायित्व उठाते हैं, तभी आप उत्तरदायित्व उठाने का आनंद ले सकते हैं. एक 20 साल का लड़का अपने पिता के पास जाता है और कहता है, मैं एक लड़की से प्रेम करता हूँ. पिता ने मूर्छित होकर कहा नहीं, वह लड़की नहीं, वह तुम्हारे बहन है. कुछ दिनों के बाद लड़का फिर से आता है और दूसरी लड़की के बारे में बताता है. पिता फिर से कहता है, नहीं, यह लड़की भी तुम्हारी बहन है. कुछ दिनों के बाद लड़का यही किस्सा फिर से होता है. लड़का बड़ी व्याकुलता के साथ माँ के पास जाता है और यह बात बताता है. माँ कहती है, दुखी ना हो बेटा, उन तीनों में से तुम कोई भी लड़की से विवाह कर सकते हो. क्यों है? क्यों कि तुम्हारा पिता कोई और है. जब आपके आसपास जो लोग हैं वह संपूर्ति में नहीं रखते, तब आप भी संपूर्ति एवं पूर्णत्व के स्थिति में नहीं रह सकते हैं.
Inner awakening, running health recoveries, 100% cure for depression, insomnia, asthma, fatigue, chronic pain, insecurity, panic attacks and other major disorders. Awaken the Kundalini Shakti, the dormant energy within. What would you do if you had 1300% more energy? Disease-free mind and body is your first wealth. Claim it at Inner Awakening. Inner Awakening, a 21-day meditation retreat with rare living incarnation, Paramahamsa Nityananda, May 8th to May 28th, 2013, Nityananda Dhyanapita, Nityananda Nagar, Biridi, Bengaluru, Karnataka. Contact
0802-727-9999.
Email ia@nityananda.org.
Nityanandam, I'm Jay Krishna, I'm from Bangalore. So far, the experience has been the ultimate in the inner awakening. I realized that unclutching is my true state. I don't have to do anything for it. More than all these states that I have experienced, what I really experienced with Swami in close quarters is Swami taught me how to eat like a mother, and he gave me the reason why I need to eat with my hands like a father. That is the experience that I would be taking away, the best experience that I would be taking away from this inner awakening. The greatest opportunity that anyone could get from these 21 days is you get to be in close quarters with Swamiji, you get to eat with him, you get to talk with him, you get to ask your most intimate questions and get the solutions that what you need. That is something which I was not expecting, apart from meditation, able to do meditation and clutching. These are all the expectations. But being able to be with Swami in such close quarters is something that I didn't expect, and that is the best thing that anyone can have. So that's what should be my takeaway from the entire Inner Awakening program.
Your life is not just yours. Whether you want it or not, understand or not, as long as others are involved in your life, you are involved in others' life. So decide enriching others' life, enriches your life. See, all the people who enjoy the infrastructures of the society, only when they enrich others' life, society enriches them. When you don't enrich others' life, your life cannot be enriched. This is the essence of what I wanted to express today. In every step, every level, when you enrich others, life enriches you. When you enrich others, life enriches you. Aapka jeevan keval aapka nahi hai. Yeh nirnay kijiye, dusro ko labanvit karna aapko labanvit karta hai. यदि आप दूसरों का को लाभान्वित नहीं करेंगे, आप स्वयं भी लाभान्वित नहीं हो सकते हैं. कंटिन्यूअसली ओनली व्हेन यू डिजायर टू एनरिच, लाइफ फ्लोस थ्रू यू. बाय एनरिचिंग अदर्स, योर ओन हार्ट स्टार्ट्स इम्बाइबिंग दोज ट्रूथ्स. लिसन, if you are struggling with some problem, you know the solution, your heart is not accepting, start giving that solution to others, your heart will listen to it. Listen, the practicing period, if it ends in success, it is called practicing period. If it ends in failure, it is called hypocrisy. Otherwise, in quality, see, while you practice, are you visualizing success in the end? Are you unconsciously imagining failure in the end? If you are unconsciously constantly imagining failure in the end, it is hypocrisy. If you are clear about visualizing success in the end of the tunnel, if the light is seen, it is practice. End of the tunnel, if the darkness is seen, it's hypocrisy. Continuously enrich, enrich, enrich. When you enrich others, you will be enriched. Because knowledge is such, only by enriching, you will expand. That is why in Hindu tradition we have this great truth as a faith. If one person becomes sannyasi, the seven generation is liberated. From your family, if anybody has become sannyasi, I can be guaranteed, especially if they are in the sampradaya of Nityananda order, I maintain such a high level of purity of sannyas in our sampradaya, I guarantee, if one person in your family has become sannyasi, your seven generation is liberated. Because they create so much of punya. Because in our sampradaya, such high integrity, authenticity, responsibility and enriching is maintained. When you enrich others, not only you, everyone around you, all their karmas are also burnt. Jab aap dusro ko labanvit karte hai, aap bhi labanvit aivam vistarit hote hai. आपके आसपास के अन्य लोग अगर संपूर्ति श्रद्धा जिम्मेदारी और लाभान्वित किए बिना जी रहे हैं, तो आप संपूर्ति श्रद्धा जिम्मेदारी और लाभान्वित करने में पूर्णत्व नहीं पाएंगे. इसीलिए लाभान्वित करना एक बहुत ही महत्वपूर्ण व्रत है. दूसरों को लाभान्वित करने से स्वयं आपका हृदय उन सत्यों को अपनाता है. यदि आप कोई समस्या के साथ संघर्ष का अनुभव कर रहे हैं, आपका हृदय आपकी बात नहीं सुन रहा है, आपके बात नहीं सुन रहा है, उस समस्या का समाधान दूसरों को दीजिए. आप देखेंगे कि आपका हृदय उसी बात को सुनता है, अपनाता है, अपनाता है. हमारे शास्त्र कहते हैं कि अगर एक मानव सन्यासी बनता है तब उसके वंश में 7 पीढ़ी लाभान्वित हो जाते हैं. हमारे शास्त्र कहते हैं कि अगर एक मानव सन्यासी बनता है तब उसके वंश में 7 पीढ़ी लाभान्वित हो जाते हैं. एनरिचिंग अदर्स इज द बेस्ट वे टू यूज योर ह्यूमन लाइफ. आई टेल यू, लाइफ इज अ फेलियर इफ यू थिंक इन योर ओल्ड एज you should have done all this when you were young. In your old age, if you think you should have done something which you have not done when you are young, life is a failure. I tell you, enriching others is the only way you will not feel your life is failure when you are old. That's the only way you will feel your life is a success. The essence of today's satsang is continuously enrich others. दूसरों को लाभान्वित करना ही आपके जीवन का सर्वोच्च सर्वोत्तम उपयोग है. आज की सत्संग का सारांश है, आपका जीवन एवं वास्तविकता स्वयं और अन्य लोगों के जीवन का मिश्रण है. इसीलिए लगातार स्वयं के साथ साथ अन्य लोगों के जीवन को भी लाभान्वित करते हैं. केवल यही एक मार्ग है जिससे आप अपने जीवन में कोई भी वास्तविकता का सृजन करके उसका अनुभव कर सकते हैं.
ಕಡಿಮೆಗೊಳಿಸಿ ನಿಮ್ಮ ನಿದ್ರೆಯನ್ನು ಉತ್ತಮಗೊಳಿಸಿ ಭಯ ಮತ್ತು ಚಿಂತೆಗಳಿಂದ ಮುಕ್ತಗೊಳ್ಳಿ ಸಂಬಂಧಗಳನ್ನು ಉತ್ತಮಗೊಳಿಸಿ ಉನ್ನತ ಚೈತನ್ಯ ಮಟ್ಟವನ್ನು ನಿಮ್ಮದಾಗಿಸಿಕೊಳ್ಳಿ. ನಿತ್ಯ ಧ್ಯಾನ ಯೋಗ ನಿಮ್ಮ ನಕಾರಾತ್ಮಕ ಮನೋವಿನ್ಯಾಸಗಳನ್ನು ತೊಡೆದುಹಾಕಿ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಶಕ್ತಿ ಕೇಂದ್ರಗಳನ್ನು ಜಾಗೃತಗೊಳಿಸುವ ಧ್ಯಾನ ಶಿಬಿರ. 7 ಪರಿವರ್ತನಾಕಾರಕ ಧ್ಯಾನ ತಂತ್ರಗಳೊಂದಿಗೆ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಜೀವನವನ್ನು ಸಶಕ್ತಗೊಳಿಸಿಕೊಳ್ಳಿ. ಆನಂದ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಜನ್ಮಸಿದ್ಧ ಹಕ್ಕು, ಅದನ್ನು ಮರಳಿ ಪಡೆಯಿರಿ. ಸಂಪರ್ಕಿಸಿ ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದ ಧ್ಯಾನಪೀಠ, ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದ ನಗರ, ಬಿಡದಿ, ಬೆಂಗಳೂರು, ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ. ದೂರವಾಣಿ ಸಂಖ್ಯೆ
0802-727-9999.
ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದೇಶ್ವರ ಸಮಾರಂಭಾಂ ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದೇಶ್ವರಿ ಮಧ್ಯಮಾಂ ಅಸ್ಮದಾಚಾರ್ಯ ಪರ್ಯಂತಾಂ ವಂದೇ ಗುರು ಪರಂಪರಾಂ. ಇಸ್ ಸಮಯ ಹಮಾರೆ ಸಾಥ್ ಉಪಸ್ಥಿತ ಸಭಿ ದರ್ಶಕೋ ಕಾ ಮೇರಾ ಪ್ರೇಮ ಏವಂ ಆಶೀರ್ವಾದ ಸಹಿತ ಸ್ವಾಗತ್. ಆಜ್ ಹಮ್ ಹಮಾರಾ 21 ದಿನ ಕೆ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮ ಇನ್ನರ್ ಅವೇಕನಿಂಗ್ ಕೆ ದ್ವಾರ ಆಪ್ಕಿ ಕುಂಡಲಿನಿ ಶಕ್ತಿ ಕೈಸೆ ಜಾಗೃತ ಹೋಕರ್ ಸ್ಥಾಯಿ ರೂಪ್ ಮೇ ಯಾ ಶಕ್ತಿ ಕೈಸೆ ಆಪ್ಕೆ ಭೀತರ್ ಸ್ಥಾಪಿತ ಹೋ ಜಾತಿ ಹೇ ಔರ್ ಆಪ್ಕೆ ಜೀವನ್ ಮೇ ಕೈಸೆ ಲಗಾತಾರ್ ಸ್ವಾಸ್ಥ್ಯ ಧನಾಕರ್ಷಣ ಪರಿಪೂರ್ಣ ಸಂಬಂಧೋ ಕಾ ಅನುಭವ ಕರ್ ಹರ್ ಕ್ಷೇತ್ರ ಮೇ ಸಫಲತಾ ಔರ್ ಸರ್ವೋಚ್ಚ ಜೀವನ್ ಮುಕ್ತಿ ಲಾತಾ ಹೇ ಉಸ್ಕೆ ಬಾರೇ ಮೇ ಬಾತ್ ಕರೆಂಗೆ. ಐಲ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಆನ್ ಹೌ ಇನ್ ಅವರ್ ಇನ್ನರ್ ಅವೇಕನಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಯುವರ್ ಕುಂಡಲಿನಿ ಈಸ್ ಅವೇಕನ್ಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹೌ ದ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಈಸ್ ಎಸ್ಟಾಬ್ಲಿಷ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ಸೈಡ್ ಯು ಪರ್ಮನೆಂಟ್ಲಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹೌ ಇಟ್ ಬ್ರಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಹೆಲ್ತ್, ವೆಲ್ತ್, ಗುಡ್ ರಿಲೇಷನ್ಶಿಪ್ಸ್, ಸಕ್ಸಸ್ ಇನ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ಆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಯುವರ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ಎನ್ಲೈಟ್ ಅಲ್ಟಿಮೇಟ್ ಎನ್ಲೈಟನ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್. ಇಫ್ ಐ ಈಕ್ವೇಟ್ ಯುವರ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಟು ಅ ಮ್ಯಾಂಗೋ ಫ್ರೂಟ್, ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಈಕ್ವೇಟ್ ಕುಂಡಲಿನಿ ಟು ದ ಸೀಡ್ ಇನ್ ಸೈಡ್. ಮ್ಯಾಂಗೋ ಫ್ರೂಟ್ ಡಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಅಚೀವ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಟಿಮೇಟ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಈಟ್ ದ ಫ್ರೂಟ್ and destroy the seed. The fruit realizes itself only when the seed is able to give more fruits. Same way, your body has two components, the kundalini in it and your body. Just living with a little money, comfort and ending your life is like eating the mango fruit, but that is not going to be the realization for the fruit itself. Fruit itself realizes its existence, its purpose of existence only when the fruits, when the seeds start giving more fruits. Listen, mango does not realize itself when just if the fruit is consumed, the pulp is consumed. Just by somebody eating the pulp of the mango fruit, the mango does not realize its high potential, highest possibility. Mango realizes its highest possibility only when seed starts giving more fruits. Your body realizes its peak only when your kundalini is awakened and established in your system. I tell you, if your kundalini is not awakened, the continuous discontentment you carry, unfulfillment you carry, you will not even know the reason, but you will go on blaming everything and you will be carrying that discontentment. It is so unfortunate, most of the human beings, whether they are in the space, they are in the place where you really envy to be, like a big social leader, big political leader, person with huge wealth, big celebrity, rich and famous. Whatever place you envy, even the people who are established in those places permanently, forever, listen, even they suffer with this great punishment of discontentment. Agar aapka deh aam ka phal hai, to kundalini shakti uska beej hai. Agar aapka kundalini shakti ka jagran nagi hoti hai, तब आप लगातार अपूर्ण स्थिति में रहते हैं और एक संघर्ष भारी जीवन को अनुभव करते हैं. फल अपने आपको तभी परिपूर्ण पाता है जब उसकी बीज द्वारा अधिक फल उत्पन्न होते हैं. When your kundalini is awakened, first thing you will experience a deep fulfillment. Such contentment. In every dimension of your life, you will see God. Too much, enough, enough. It's overflowing. The overflowing experience of life will be tasted by your biomemory first time. Very rarely, your muscle memory taste the overflowing experience, but unfortunately, because it is immediately forgotten, biomemory never experiences. For every human being, kundalini awakening is a basic need. Till then, you will be having the deep unfulfillment in some form or other. जब आपकी कुंडलिनी शक्ति जागृत होती है, तब आप एक अद्भुत और गहरी पूर्णत्व स्थिति को अनुभव करते हैं. आपके शरीर में भी दो हिस्से हैं, कुंडलिनी शक्ति और आपका शरीर. केवल थोड़ा पैसा, थोड़ा आराम एक आम खाने के समान है, किंतु वो उस फल की परिपूर्णता नहीं है. फल तभी अपनी जीवन का अस्तित्व तभी समझता है जब उसका बीज अनेक फल देता है. आई विल टेल यू, समहाउ फाइंड द राइट मास्टर एंड अवेकन योर कुंडलिनी, समहाउ. Because only then new life starts. Let you all achieve, experience, live, express, radiate, share, and explode in eternal bliss. Nityananda.
Nityananda Dhyana Peetham, Nityananda Nagar, off Mysore Road, Bidadi, Bengaluru. Phone 08027279999 www.nityananda.org www.youtube.com/lifebliss foundation.